By Rufus Wainwright, an American-Canadian singer-songwriter. He wrote this one for the soundtrack of the movie Brokeback Mountain. I think it's almost the last track of the album. It is being played at the end credits of the movie, indeed. Tragic love story movie, and the song fits it really, really well. Anyway, the soundtrack is gorgeous, by the way. It is mainly written by a guitar player from Argentina, Gustavo Santolalla, but there are also tracks on there from Emmy Lou Harris, Linda Ronstadt, Teddy Thompson. Well, check it out, it is absolutely gorgeous. Now, the maker makes there. He plays it actually on a piano, very beautiful sounding piano, and I just wanted to play it on a guitar as well. It is pretty doable, I'd say. It's in the key of G, although the main thing happening for G major in this song, it's being played with a D in the bass. Yes, that's just how he does it on the piano, playing chords with both hands and then just starting, obviously, with... Well, he plays it in A-flat, by the way, so that's why we're capoed here on the first fret. And then played, indeed, a half step down, so that would be G. Again, with a D in the bass. Which you can do in a couple of different ways. I like to do it like this, which is actually just like a barred G major. But again, I don't need this low G there in the bass. I need the D, which is here on the 5th fret of the 5th string there. So that would be chord 1 throughout the song. Then D dominant 7 is in there, there's an E minor in there, D sharp, augmented. There are chords in there which sound way harder than they are. D sharp augmented, yes, and then to this one, and a C sharp minor 7 flat 5. Very long name. It is really like a C sharp minor, and then you have a flat at 7, and you have a flat at 5th in there. Like this. I will show you all those chords and their fingerings, of course, in this lesson. Now, the progression is pretty straightforward. Forward mostly, I think. The challenge really remains in just moving smoothly from chord to chord. You don't want to, you know, cut off notes or go too late, or, you know, or when you, or sometimes you need to hang on to notes instead of, you know, taking off. I will thoroughly talk you through those details as well. Another thing for this, as for the picking, indeed, it is in 3/4 time. Swing feel, that is, so it's really like a 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and what he does is like 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2, 3 and 1. So that's what we're going to copy on the guitar there. 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2, 3 and 1. So in this case, I'm playing two bass notes, then the chords on beats 2 and 3, and another bass note at the end of beat 3. Sometimes, though, you need to do it when you have only 4 strings available when playing D dominant 7, for example. Then you would play those ends of 1 and 3 with your index. 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and 2, 3 and 1 and so on. So I'll give you a close-up look for how that goes, obviously. Another thing. So this is an arrangement indeed down here on the guitar that is... However, the voicings that he is using on the piano are pretty high. He is with his left hand like pretty much in octave 3 and 4, and for the chords, well, he plays chords with both hands, I do believe. So for the right hand, pretty much in octave 4 and 5, so that's pretty high. Which would end up, if you would use the top notes as the starting point there, you would get there. This is a G chord, actually. 3 notes of a G chord. D, E, F, G on the 7th fret with a D in the bass, which you obviously have on the 4th string open. That's really nice. And then you would get this. I actually really like this as well. Show you the descending line there. One more chain doesn't make a man lasting through. So that's how that would go. You need close to the piano arrangement. So actually going through 2 arrangements there, and then you decide which one you like best. I actually like both of them. I can't capoed up, well you can, but then those voicings sound really, really high, so personally I would go for down here and then capoed up to match it a little bit better with the range of my voice. Anyway, now, so all this and probably more in this lesson, which you can check out at totallyguitars.com.